Hey everybody, I'm Philip.
And I'm Nick.
And today we're here to talk about Universal Analytics, which, as you might have heard, just recently came out of beta, and we've had our public launch. And we've taken a bunch of questions from users and the community, and we wanted to just take some time to answer them and just give everyone a general overview of what Universal Analytics is. So Nick, why don't you talk about just what it is for maybe people that haven't heard yet?
Yeah, it's a great question. So Universal Analytics is a huge fundamental shift for Google Analytics. Mm-hmm. Really came about with the fact that today, users are using more devices than ever to research and learn about businesses. Now, for analysts, this is becoming really difficult. Mm-hmm. In the past, when you just looked at your website, it was easy to just have web tracking. But now, as users are interacting with your business across all these touch points, we needed to rethink how analytics works to allow mm-hmm. customer businesses to actually understand all the different touch points that users are interacting, as well as understand how users are acting across those touch points. So Universal Analytics is really to solve that problem of how we can provide a better view of all the touch points users are using to interact with your business.
Okay. And so what are some of the differences between Universal Analytics and maybe what we'll call classic analytics, what it was before Universal Analytics?
Well, it really comes down into some fundamental technical things.
Okay.
One of the technical things was that in the past, when the web was the center of the world, it was that cookies where we were using to persist information. Mm-hmm. And so all your campaign data and all of your visitor history information, like how many sessions you've had, that was all stored in the cookie. Mm-hmm. So as soon as we started taking that environment out of the web and started talking about mobile and tablet and just devices, these cookies didn't really translate well.
Right.
And so what we did is we actually ripped out a lot of the information, all that state from that we were using the cookies, and we pushed it to the server. So now, with Universal Analytics, there's a very easy way you could send data into the platform, regardless of the device you're on.
Right.
In fact, all you need is an ID that identifies a user, as well as the information about that interaction. And you can now measure any sort of touch point, regardless if it's mobile, a tablet, kiosk, game console. It's all available to measure now with Google Analytics.
Right, because before, if I had a cookie in my web browser, but then I went and used my phone later, there would be no way to know that it was the same person.
Right.
So now we can solve that problem, the cross-device.
Well, it's a good question, yeah. So the first thing is we can actually send the data from these different devices.
Right.
The second part of Universal Analytics is this feature we call User ID Override. And it's the ability, if you have a logged in user, that you can actually explicitly set the ID of that user. So if they're logged into the web and logged into the mobile application, you could explicitly set the same IDs. So now we have the ability to actually measure this user across multiple devices.
Right, right. Yeah. So it was in beta, and now it's not in beta. Now it's been publicly launched. So what does that mean? What are the differences? What can users expect now that it's no longer beta?
Right, so this change took a lot of work from a lot of engineering effort to actually move all our systems to use Universal Analytics. So that took some time. With the public launch, which we announced a couple weeks ago, we announced a couple really key big things. First, it was completely out of beta, so it's publicly available for all users. Mm-hmm. The second thing is we now achieved 100% feature capability. So all the features that we didn't support in the past, we now support. For example, remarketing, audience reports, all of these double-click integration features are now natively supported with Universal Analytics.
And to be clear, these were things that were supported in classic analytics, were not supported in the beta phase of Universal Analytics. But now that it's out of beta, these things are supported.
Exactly.
So everything you could do in classic analytics, you can now do.
You can now do in Universal Analytics.
Great.
There's a couple small other things that we did. One is the new experience for all new properties is that you're always be Universal Analytics by default. So okay. That was a big thing. The other thing we also rolled out, which was really nice, is a feature we call time zone-based processing. That gives you the ability so that the data in your analytics account is now processed with the time zone that's configured for that view. In the past, it was all Pacific time, and now it's view. So customers in Japan and Australia are really loving this because now they actually get fresher data.
Right.
The other thing is we announced that we're going to start publicly rolling out the User ID Override feature, which mm-hmm. we've talked about for a while, but we'll now actually start rolling that out. And then the last part of our announcement was the ability in the measurement protocol, again, this is the way that you actually send data from any device, to override the IP and user agent fields. This was a huge developer feature request and allows you to now proxy data from a server. So you can now do server-to-server communication.
Right.
So with Universal Analytics, it's not just about devices. It's also about servers mm-hmm. because they actually have a lot of important data. We can now properly measure that within analytics.
Okay. Well, let's go to some user questions. The kind of most common question that we got was, what will happen to my data after I upgrade? There's, you know, a little bit of fear. Am I going to lose some of it? Is there going to be downtime?
Yeah.
You know, what would you say to those users?
So it's a great question. The upgrade has actually two steps. And the first step is that you actually transfer processing from Classic to Universal Analytics. Mm-hmm. The second step is then you retag from the Classic GAJS code to the new Universal code, which is AnalyticsJS.
So where do you transfer? You said the first step. Where do you do that first step?
Right. So in the admin interface, there is a section under the property. And if it's still a Classic property, you can actually go in and manually go through the process and say you want to upgrade. You start to transfer the processing from Classic to Universal Analytics.
So you do it on the Google Analytics
on the
website.
Site, yeah.
Yes.
And so when people actually take their Classic property and transfer processing to Universal Analytics, we see a very, like, we work really hard to make sure that there is no data inconsistencies. Mm-hmm. So people see potentially like less than 1% change in that one day, but longer term, we still maintain all of your visitor history. So if we know the user came back to your site 5 times, we'll still remember that. Mm-hmm. And we still remember all the campaign information. Okay. So it's a very small change when you actually transfer processing.
So that step anybody can do. Anybody with access to, you know, with authorization to go in and manage their analytics.
Anybody with
account
admin access.
Can change it.
Correct.
So that you said there's a second part.
Right. The second part of the upgrade process is to actually re-tag your site with the Classic code from GAJS to the new Universal code, AnalyticsJS.
Right.
And so that process is sometimes more involved. Mm-hmm. And so you can actually continue, the way we've designed the system is that you can actually continue sending the Classic GAJS data into Universal Analytics. It will process it. Mm-hmm. So that still works.
So that segues nicely into the next question that we got a lot. Do I have to change the code of my website? And so it sounds like the answer is no. You don't really have to change the code on your website, at least not right now.
Right now, you don't have to change the code. We've really designed it to work well. And we know that re-implementing tracking code can be very difficult. Mm-hmm. So what we've actually even designed is that you can actually implement on the same website, you can partially re-tag. Part of the website can be Classic JHS, and the other part could be AnalyticsJS. You can't have them on the same page, but you can have them on different pages sending data to the same property. So if you can't actually get to your whole site, you can actually start implementing AnalyticsJS and getting some of the features of that new tracking code on those pages.
Okay.
Now, there is a kind of a broader story here. And what we announced was the public launch of Universal Analytics. Our goal for this project is to actually get 100% of Google Analytics properties to be processing by Universal Analytics. Mm-hmm. And that's a huge goal. Mm-hmm. And we have a lot of great people who are opting in. The other part of it is that over time, we'll be manually transferring properties to Universal Analytics. And so once 100 people actually move to Universal Analytics, we will then enter the next phase of the upgrade process. And that will actually be where we announce that Universal Analytics is the operating standard for all customers. Mm-hmm. And at that point, we will announce the deprecation of GAJS. And so what that means is that we'll continue to support processing data from GAJS, the Classic code, right, for a minimum of 2 years.
Right. So if I do nothing right now, there's a chance that everything will just be fine for some time to come now.
For it's like not, 2.5 right, years.
You probably should upgrade, but it's not urgent if you can't.
If
you don't have the means to do it right now.
Now, that being said, there are a lot of new features that we're adding to AnalyticsJS.
Exactly.
And actually, the way we're developing product now is that all new features will be Universal Analytics only. So over time, there will be a huge feature gap between old and new. So we do encourage everybody to actually re-tag when they have the opportunity.
Right. So the next question, we addressed it a little bit already. But I mentioned that, you know, a lot of users asked during beta that some users were recommended not to upgrade because certain things weren't available to them. And right now, is there any reason why somebody shouldn't upgrade?
Right now, we think everybody should upgrade. So the big thing was that we didn't have all the feature support. But with the public launch, we support all the features. Now is the best time to start considering planning of how to upgrade. And again, it's a two-step process. The processing part of it can just be done by the admin with a couple clicks. Mm-hmm. The retagging, you can still wait for a later time.
Okay.
But it's definitely something people should look into.
So you mentioned that some people were going to get automatically upgraded. Now, that might sound scary to some people. You know, maybe they don't want to upgrade. Should people be worried about that? I mean, that's kind of the next question that was commonly asked.
It's a great question. And so, again, the goal here is to get, the goal is that we want to bring great features and products on Universal Analytics to market. Mm-hmm. So we need, the goal is to get 100% of all our properties to using Universal Analytics. We know some people will upgrade, or some people will do the transferring. Mm-hmm. But for the customers who don't, we'll start auto-transferring those properties. And again, because we have full feature support, there's nothing to worry that you will be missing features. Mm-hmm. Because we're processing all the classic data that you're sending, again, there will be minimal data discrepancies. Mm-hmm. We actually have now in the change log, in your analytics account management change log, we actually show like when the transfer has started. So if Google has initiated this for your property, you can actually see this in that change. But the goal here is that way, because the impact is so small for doing the transfer, we'll just go ahead and start transferring.
And as we already mentioned, because the old code on your website still works in Universal Analytics, if Google auto-transfers somebody and they're not even aware of it, it's fine.
It should be fine,
nothing happens. The next question is, when will this happen? When will people start being forced that currently haven't made the switch yet?
Right, so when will we auto-transfer people?
Yeah.
So we're working on a long-term plan. There's a lot of users. What we'll be doing is increasingly for sites that send us more data, we'll be increasingly transferring them to Universal Analytics. Our goal is then to, certain customers have different integrations with analytics, like AdSense and AdWords. Mm-hmm. So then we'll go to that phase. And then finally, the last part of it is our premium customers. We're going to give our premium customers the most time to actually go in and manually do this, mm-hmm. or to make sure everything's okay.
Mm-hmm. Great. So some people have asked, if I upgrade a property to Universal Analytics, will my automated reports still work?
Yes. Everything in the product will continue to work.
So the API, just to clarify, the API has not changed, the reporting API.
Right.
It's just the way the data is being collected has changed.
The way we collect data and the way we process data has changed.
Right.
The actual reporting continues to use the same process data. So that'll all be transparent. All the scheduled reports in the product, or the API, or even the reports in the product, everything will be consistent.
And even if I've written my own application that uses the API on some schedule to get new data every once in a while, that shouldn't change at all.
That won't change.
It won't be affected. Great. One question we had was that classic analytics supports features like custom variables. Now, in Universal Analytics, we don't have custom variables anymore. We have something called custom dimensions.
Right.
Do you want to talk a little bit about that? And are those things being automatically transferred, or how does that work?
Right. So custom variables was our original feature that allow you to bring your custom business data through the tracking code. Mm-hmm. Custom dimensions is the next evolution of that feature. And unfortunately, these two features were not able to make them compatible with one another. Mm-hmm. So the way it works in Universal Analytics is that when you transfer, or if you are using an analytics property, you could still send custom variable data with the classic tracking code. And we'll continue to process that just as we did in the past. But if you start using analytics.js, the new Universal Analytics tracking code,
right,
that does not have support for custom variables. It only has support for custom dimensions.
I see.
So there is a trade-off between, when should you start moving from custom variables to custom dimensions? Mm-hmm. And again, this is something that we tried really hard to figure out a migration path, and it just didn't quite work with the new model. Now, of course, the new model is more flexible for a bunch of things that we're working on. But longer term, we'd love for people to come up with a plan on how they can move from variables to dimensions.
Great.
Yeah.
So are there really any reasons at all why somebody shouldn't upgrade to Universal Analytics? If somebody came in here and they had, they were skeptical, they had all sorts of the most customized site possible, what would you say to that person?
Right. So we've tested it. We have 100% feature support. We really think at this point, everybody is ready to start doing the upgrade process. So if anybody hasn't done it already, it's definitely something to take a look at. Mm-hmm. And of course, for people who just don't have the time or is not using analytics anymore, unfortunately, we'll be auto-transferring those properties over the next coming months.
Okay. So if people had questions, wanted more information, where should they go?
It's a great question. So we've really tried, with these big platform changes, there's a lot of questions. So we have a couple great resources for people to use. The first one is if you don't know what Universal Analytics is, we have a help center that can help articulate all the features and benefits. If you're specifically looking for information on the upgrade, we actually have a whole upgrade center that really talks you through the benefits, the timelines. We've actually published the whole timelines that we've talked about. Mm-hmm. It also talks about, it has specific migration guides that actually talk you through what code changes you need to do when you retag. Finally, for people who still have questions, there's always people who have questions, we actually have a public Google group mm-hmm. for upgrade that people can actually ask questions and our engineers take a look at them to make sure if there's any bugs that we're actually addressing them.
Well, thanks everybody for watching. Hopefully you learned something about Universal Analytics. Once again, if you have some questions, the resources that Nick just mentioned are a great place to look. And once again, my name is Philip.
And I'm Nick, and I hope you have a great time.